Welcome back everyone of the Kelly Squad to a new video. Today we are actually in a new game that just came out. It's called My Dragon, and till now I am pretty surprised with the quality of it. It's a really good quality. I haven't experienced any lag yet. It's still an alpha, so expect some bugs or issues. So don't be too excited yet, but I wanted to show this game already to my fans, because I think they will like this game. So, welcome to My Dragon. Till now, there are a few things that I noticed you can do. You can build your camp. I have no idea why this big thing is coming soon. Probably extension of your camp. But right now, I am here in my camp. So, what can I do in my camp? Well, I will show you, because my tutorial is not entirely ended yet. I did do some testing, and my data just got reset a lot of times, so don't worry about that. So, we'll walk to the generator merchant and purchase a generator. So let's do that. Let's go to the generators. We can actually purchase over here one tire. It doesn't say that it's free right now, but it is free, the first one. You can purchase it, so let me close the chat. You're gonna purchase it, and you will get this little area that shows you, it's like a chest opening. It shows you what kind of generator you will get. And boom, we got the first one. It's a coin generator. It has average speed, but only a small storage. So now you go over here, and this is the area we currently have. You can place your generator down. You can basically just generate the area how you want to. So like, I can go over here, I can rotate it like I want it like that, or can I zoom in a bit? Thank you. So you can just drag it around if you want to. Mine is a little bit bugged right now for some reason. Not sure. That's why. So let's just put it over here, rotate it a bit. It says that I have this entire area, but for some reason it doesn't really let me put it over here. So let's just put the first one pretty close by. Let's see what areas we are allowed. Okay, well, that seems pretty good. Maybe I can... Well, we're just gonna drag it here and then build it with C. Just gonna build it. As you can see, it takes a little while before it's built. So like it says, your generator is now being built, please wait until it's built. So we're just gonna wait until the generator is like built. And you can even climb this stuff, by the way, while it's generated. It's kind of funny, because I've never seen that kind of interaction before. Normally they close it off so you cannot jump on the items and stuff, but it's kind of funny that you can jump on it. And I don't think it damages anything, like if it's after it's built. No, you can just jump on it. As you can see now, our generator is built. We achieved something over here. We can close that. We built our generator. So our generator, you can click on it, then open it, and you can collect your coins. So that's all about coin collection. It will pop up here that you have collected your coins and everything. You can see your coins on the right top corner. And these are like some kind of orbs kind of stuff that you can also go. So it tells me to follow arrow, which means we are going towards the town right now. You can see people here, by the way, in your camp, but you cannot see what they are building. So you don't really experience the lack of everyone building at the same time, but you can still see each other, which I actually really like, because it's your personal space, but also not your personal space. So it's kind of cool. So let's go to the town. It's gonna load in a little bit. By the way, the person that does your little welcome to the town, thank you. The person that does your little tutorial is actually your a developer of the game. So that's interesting. Kind of funny adjustments that the developers, of course, do the. So over here you can unlock worlds. You can actually currently unlock earth and water, and if you collect orbs together, we can actually open the big 1 million portal, the fire world. So we can go into the world, become a dragon, and fight over there. But I first want to check in with the trainer and stuff. So right now, it tells you how many orbs you have. Need to actually train, slash evolve your dragon, unlock new abilities and everything. My mouse feels really slow when I open this UI. So I do have to mention something about that. But you can see like this new stomper belly, you unlock a new dragon, you get coins and you get a bigger generation gap. So that's what the trainer does. It's basically it's like evolving and customized dragon. Over here you can find abilities, train your dragon to unlock new abilities. Click here to go to the dragon trainer. Well, the dragon trainer is over there. And there you can basically equip your abilities currently. Little fountain over there. I really love how the world is made. It's really detailed. I love the medieval style. I really like that kind of time zone. And I really love how it's built. It has the normal nature feature from Roblox Studios. But it also has like the customization of this low poly. Is it actually low poly? I think it's kind of low poly. Low poly effect. So here you have customization. Here you can actually buy for some Robux, some skins and armor and everything for your dragons. And it's just a cute extra addiction to the thing. I don't know what's coming soon, but there might be more than this. I do hope that eventually they add some customizations and everything for people that cannot spend Robux, because it would be really sad if this is a game mainly focused on spending Robux, because that means that those who are free to play will not have these cute additions. And I think that through events or quests that you should be able to receive these kind of additions to Watch Your Dragon, of course. So that's everything for customization. Over here you see generators, that one you also have for your cam. Here you have decorations, which is actually interesting because this is basically for your cam. Here you can buy decorations to make your cam look more prettier than it already is. So of course you're gonna get some dirt beds to watch your generators. Maybe a market stand. I don't even know what a market stand does, but whatever. But that's definitely interesting. I got some kind of ping right now. Oh, might it be because my friend joined? I'm not sure. I see that a lot of Dutch people are actually playing this, which is interesting because I'm Dutch myself. So I think it does kind of target Europe area. Or maybe I got coins. I think I got coins or something. So I have no idea what's over here. There's a big statue. There are some houses. Oh, this is... Oh my god. This is actually a way so you can visit other camps. That is amazing. Even though this one is a little bit glitched over here. Because it says that it's my camp and someone else's camp. So I do really need to report that one. Because it's clearly that there are two camps stuck in here. So I'm just going to take a quick screenshot to put that in a bug form later. But whoa. That's actually really amazingly done. And then you have a little like statue over here. Ah, oh, we can't climb it. But whoa, that statue looks actually pretty good. How did they do that? Yo, that looks pretty good. I like it. I love it. So let's go to into our first world so I can show you guys how it is to become a dragon. So I'm going to the Earth world because I have to unlock that world. Yes, you go straight to the portal, but it takes a little while before it pops up. It's like, do you want to unlock the first Earth? And you say, yes, I want to unlock it. You successfully unlocked the successfully purchased Earth world. Okay, that's good. So now we can go into this world. It's going to load. It's going to bring us there. So let's just wait a little bit till we got there. And I got a message from someone with a hat and a Santa hat on it. So I am going into this now. I'm going to skip loading because basically my loading is just good. You can actually see each other dragon here, which is very interesting. I don't. This guy seems to be pretty laggy. You can also see who they are defeating, which is also useful. I helped out people with defeating the orc in this area before. The minions don't seem to attack me. I didn't know that this is still an issue, so in World 1 that's definitely an issue to keep an eye on. But like, this is how you be a dragon. You click to basically do basic attacks. You shift to run. Q is dashing sidewards, E is dashing sidewards to the right. Z is dashing backwards. And something I didn't notice, but there is an R button or an E. No, R button. There's an R button and it basically lets your It lets your dragon spread like this fire out of his mouth. So that way you can easier defeat bosses and stuff. So what the thing is like over here you see all these minions that you can defeat and stuff. And you need to defeat these minions to eventually, I want to show you guys it, but it's a little bit of a long run. And I don't want to edit too much, so I will just do the long run so you guys can see a little bit of the first world. Get spoiled a little bit. Okay, we should be almost here because I noticed this area. Yeah, this is checkpoint. So basically, normally you would have to, there are borders around here. You have to collect a certain amount of orbs to get past those borders. I already actually did this boss before, so I don't think I need to do this. And I think that my stats are a little bit weird, considering it says that I do need... Oh. I don't think it's attacking me, is it? Oh my gosh, it is. Never mind, it is. Woo! Nope. Ah, I died. Woo! That was harder than I thought it would be. But, yes, I want to load to the left. That's the first point. Good. But basically, you have to open those borders to get past it, and then you just walk further towards the end. This should be a dragon boss again. I mean, I already did this, so I'm like, I'm not entirely sure if my progress like saved or something. I cannot see anything. By the way, with control, you can go out of your dragon and actually look at the Talmud. Oh, I can go back to the town. Okay, that's a good thing. So I'm going back to the town for a second. But that's how you use your dragon and everything. I really started loving this game already. It does save when one of your generators is full. That's actually a really useful need, because then you know when to go to your camp again. But I really love this game already, because there are a lot of aspects to it. And I think it can go really far, considering what they already put inside of the game. And I think a lot of people could be interested in this game. Especially that you have to open new worlds together. Like, there would be probably a lot of teamwork with people. Is that why am I even loading in? I can skip loading. But I think there will be a lot of teamwork together. Like, people really working together to open that portal to the fire world and stuff. But I hope that developers do realize that people can be working really hard together. So, why did that open? I didn't even click on it. But like, it can go really quick. So I hope they are prepared for opening actually the new world once the achievement got unlocked. So my problem is that my camp is also in here. Whoa, what the... Now there are more people than what? What the? Yo. Okay. Well, whatever. Oh, hey. Now my camp is here. That's cool. Okay, yeah. That's cool. I like it. But, I hope they are just prepared and stuff. And they do need to fix this kind of camp bug, though. It's kind of annoying. That way you cannot enter someone's certain camp. But that's fine. So guys, I hope you come play with the guys. I put the link into the description, of course. Got a lot of descriptions these days. And I hope to see you guys and that you guys play some My Dragon with me. And I'll see you guys later. Bye bye. Hey, before you go, don't forget to sub and like this video. I'll see you guys later.